Hey, hi, hello everybody. Today we're gonna see something called as Scratch. In Scratch, we're gonna create our own virtual pet. So, welcome. So, how do you open a Scratch? To open a Scratch, we need a browser like this. So, I'm using a Chrome browser. You can use any browser, like Chrome browser, Firefox, Opera, or Microsoft Edge. You can use any kind of browser. And here, like, I'm gonna search for Scratch. So S-C-R-A-T-C-H. So when you type Scratch in a browser in the search engine, you get a series of results, and we have to click on the first link. So when I click on the first link, we get to see a Scratch website. Yeah, this is a Scratch website, and where we're gonna do our Scratch project. In Scratch project, we have a Scratch editor. How to go to a Scratch editor? Like when you click on this create, we're gonna go to our Scratch editor. What is the Scratch editor? Is Scratch editor is a place where we can create our own projects, something like animation, games, story, or many more things. Now let's go to Scratch editor. Let's click on create. If you have any doubt, what you can do is you can just come back and you can watch the steps again, and you can try it out. Not only these steps, and the steps which we're gonna show further. So at any point of time, if you couldn't find any, if you are confused with something, you can pause the video and you can just come back and you can watch over. So let's start. What is this virtual pet? So we know what is pet, but what is this virtual pet? So I'll show you some of the examples I have created for you. So here we can see we have a cat. So this is a virtual pet. Yeah, so we have a virtual cat pet. So why it's called virtual? Because it is there only inside the computer, is not next to us. So as it is there only inside the computer, that's why we call it as virtual. And this is our pet here. Let me click on flag. When we click on the flag, any game or any animation or anything, the Scratch starts. And how do we stop it? Next to that, we can find a red dot. By clicking on this red dot, everything stops. Now let's start. Now you can see there is something around this cat. Let me click on this. It's a chocolate. Our cats don't like chocolate, and health has gone one. Let's give some medicine so that it'll get cured. Oh yeah, he's so the cat is so happy. Let's feed the cat. Yeah, we'll give some chill pills. Yeah, we'll give some more food. Uh-oh, no worries.
Yeah.
The poop is cleaned, yeah. And if you can also play a game with this. If you have to type yes or no, let me type yes. And I can play a game. It's a maze game. And once I'm here, I am supposed to click on done. You won. So this is one of a virtual pet example. And also we have a guinea pig here. And let's try something with a guinea pig. Yeah. Did you see that? The guinea pig stands first. And let's also put the cost. Let's go to sleep. Let's also feed the guinea pig. And let's also give some water. Drink some water. And let's put the guinea pig on the wheel now. Something went wrong. Just a second. Yes. Ta-da! Last but not the least, with a hedgehog. And by clicking on this, it screams. We can feed the hedgehog. We can make the hedgehog dance. How is the dance? And we can also make him sleep. That's awesome, right? So these are a few examples. Still, you can add your own creativity and you can create your own virtual pet. But how this is done? So I'm going to show you one small example so that you can have a look and you can try it on your own. And also, don't forget to add something on your own creativity. Yes. Now, quickly, we're going to do it something like this. So I'm going to take this character that was a hedgehog. So here we have a cat. Let me delete the cat. In order to delete the cat, but before that, I just forgot to tell you what is this, what is what in our Scratch editor. You see this area. This area is called as palette, where we find all the coding blocks. If you scroll down, you can find a lot of blocks here. So this place is called as coding palette. And this place is called as the editing area or the coding area, where we're going to drag and drop all the codes here. So that's why it's called as coding area. And here we are not going to type any code. We're going to use the blocks, the code which is already there in the blocks. This is called as block coding. Let's put this blocks back. So this is a palette. This is a coding area, and this is called as a stage where we see our animations or a game, anything what we design. So this is called as the stage, and just below the stage we have a section here. This is called a sprite panel, where we can change the positions like X, Y, change the size, and also choose a character that is a sprite. The characters in the Scratch is called a sprite, and also we can put a backdrop. And so the characters which we have will be shown here, or the sprite which we have will be shown here. How can we delete the sprite? By clicking on this, we'll delete the sprite. So quickly, we'll start this by clicking on this. We're going to delete this sprite. And let's add a new sprite. To add a new sprite or a new character, we have to go on this. Okay, let's go on this. And what are these? So when you click on this, you're going to choose a new sprite. When you click on this, you're going to create your own sprite. That is, you're going to use tools to create your own sprite. And when you click on this, randomly a sprite is chosen. And when you click on this upload sprite, you can upload your own sprite if it's there in your computer. So let's go for the sprite which is there in Scratch. So we're gonna click on this. So these are the characters or the sprite which we have in the Scratch. And also we can see some categories here. If you want only animals, if it's difficult to find the animals here, because it's like a mixture of everything here, human, animals, fruits. So when you click on animals, you get to see only animals. When you click on people, you get to see only people here. Like that, we have many categories. When you click on food, you get to see only food. Delicious. So we'll go back to animal. We'll choose one pet for us. I'll go for this character. Before choosing a character or a sprite, what you can do is you can keep your cursor like this, the mouse cursor on the character. You can see what this character does. So let me keep it here. So you can see what this character does. Let me keep it here. You can see what this character does on this jellyfish, on this horse. And we have flying hippo, my favorite. Now let's choose this. You can see that it can do multiple things. It can sleep, it can also move. It has a different moving animation so that we can make a dance out of this. So let me click it on this. So here we have a pet, let it be in the center. And also we need a backdrop, correct? So in order to get a backdrop, this is a place where we get a sprite or a character. If we go next to this, we can choose a backdrop. Let's click on this. Here also the same thing. The first, if you click on this, we can choose a backdrop which is there in Scratch. If you click on this, we can paint your own backdrop. If you click on this, you'll get a random backdrop from the Scratch. When you click on this, you can upload your own backdrop which is there in your computer. So let me click on this. Let me choose a background from the sprite. So here also we have lot of backdrops. And here also we have different categories like fantasy, music, sports, outdoors, indoors, space, underwater, pattern. So let me go for outdoors so that I can get forest. We can place a hedgehog over there. So let me take this one. Or scroll down, you can see like many, like everything looks so nice. Let me go for this. Yeah, let me place my hedgehog here. And if you want to decrease the size or increase the size, you can always go here. Now the default size or the original size is 100, so you can increase it or you can decrease it. I want to make it small, so I'll decrease it from 100 to 60. So this is perfect. 60 is too small, I feel. So let me make it as 80. Yes, perfect. And now what I'll do is, yes, let's start this animation. First of all, I'm going to go to controls and I'm going to find when flag. Sorry, I'm going to go to events and I'm going to find when flag clicked. As I told you before, all the games and the animation starts when the flag is clicked. So we're going to take this block which says when this flag is clicked. So whenever this flag is clicked, whatever there under this will it'll work or it'll execute. So first, what we're going to do is, so we have to fix this position. So I'll go to motion and I'll take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the fifth block. You can see the fifth block, it says go to X some number, go to Y some number. We're going to take this. What happens, why we need to use this? Because if I place this character anywhere, if I click on flag, it's going to come back to the same place. So when I click on the flag, wherever the character it is, it's going to come on minus 80, that is on X, and minus 1 on Y. How do we get to know minus 80, minus 1? So let me show you. We have a pattern at the end. Yes. So you can see that at the center, both the X value and the Y value will be 0. See, if I move this character here, you can see this X value changing, Y value changing here. If I place it here, it changes. If I place it here, you can see the number changes. How do you get to know this number? That's why I have this picture here, this backdrop here. So if the characters are at the center or the sprite is at the center, we get 0, 0. So let me put X0, Y0. You can see that the character is in the center. As it goes towards left hand side, the X value goes minus. You can see that it is minus 107. Now it becomes minus 172. Now it becomes minus 0 or minus 203. The minus value increases. And if it goes forward, on the right hand side, you can see the number increases, the positive value increases. See, the same way, like, yes, so you can see that this number keep changing. So these place, like these two boxes, X will be plus, in these two boxes, X will be minus. Now that is X value is done. Now let's see what is Y. So when we keep going down, yes, you might have guessed it right. If it keeps going down, it will be minus. We can see the Y value as minus 52, still goes minus 59, still goes further down, it will be minus 118, minus 143, minus 165. If you put it here, it's 102. See, you can see that it is now a positive number. See, the number keeps increasing in positive value. So this is how. But how do I remember this? You don't even have to remember, like, you can, whenever you want, wherever you want the character, you can place it there and you can look for that number and we can change it here. So let me go back to my previous backdrop. So when I click on this backdrop and I click on this backdrop here, I can see what are the backdrops I have. I have an empty backdrop. I have a forest that is a woodland something. Backdrop and this backdrop. Let me delete this and also let me delete this. Now I'll come back to the hedgehog. Let me click on the hedgehog. We can see the hedgehog. We are in costumes. Let's go back to code. But whenever you get to see this, if you want to go back, there is three tabs you can see over here. One is code, another one is costume, another one is sound. If you want a sound, you can choose a sound from here. If you go to costume, you can see what all this hedgehog can do. And if you click on code, we can code for it. So when I flag clicked, it's going to go to this position X minus 80, X and Y minus 1, like this. Now this is in the place. So first we'll start feeding our character. To feed a character, we need something to feed. So let me take an apple. So here we got an apple. Let me place an apple here. The apple looks very big. So let me reduce the size. So we're going to go to sprite panel and we're going to reduce the size. It's by default, it's 100. Let me make it as 50, I guess. 50 is the right size. Yes, 50 is the right size. And let me keep it down somewhere here. You can keep it anywhere, it doesn't matter. So let's fix this position to what we're going to do. We're going to go to events. When flag clicked, it's going to, wherever it is, it's going to come back to this place. That is X 45 and Y minus 125. Which value is that? Currently, it is at X 45 and Y value of this is minus 125. Where you can see, other than this, you can also see it here. X 45 minus 125. So by clicking on this, the hedgehog should come. No, by clicking on this, this apple should go to a hedgehog and hedgehog should eat it. So let me click on the flag. It goes back. Yes. Now by clicking on it. Okay. So by clicking on it, there is another block. So if you go to events, we have this when this sprite is clicked. So that's the third block. 1, 2, 3. The third block, which says, when this sprite click, which sprite? Now, which is selected? You can see apple is selected, and also you can see this apple. When this sprite is clicked, that is, when this apple sprite is clicked, what should happen? When this apple click, apple sprite is clicked, it should go to our hedgehog. So go to our hedgehog. We're gonna go to motion. Anything related to motion, anything related to moving, like we have to come back, come to this motion. And we're going to use something called as glide. The difference between the glide and go to is go to, like, directly it goes. If you can see here, I'll put it here. Click on this. It just disappears from here and it appears here. But whereas glide, what happens is, so glide, so I have selected apple. So glide 1 second to random position. When I click on this, you can see that it just glides. We can see that it is moving. Whereas in go to, it just vanish and appears. So what we're going to do is when the sprite is clicked, it's going to glide 1 second, where not to a random position, but to our hedgehog. And let me try this. So when I click on the flag, it goes to the position. When I click on this sprite, that is our, you can see which this sprite, which is that this sprite, this apple. So let me click on this apple. Ta-da! It just went to our hedgehog, but it has to make some sound, correct? And if we go to sound, we have some sound here, so let's listen to that. So we have a sound. Nice, this is a good sound. So what we'll do is here, motion, look, sound. Let's go to sound, and here we have start sound, chomp. Let's see that. So let me click on this. Yeah, it looks as though the character ate the apple, and after a few seconds a new apple should appear here. How can we do this after a few seconds? Okay, how can we do this? So we're gonna, after a few seconds, for that we're gonna go to control. So wait for a few seconds, like it's gonna wait for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, it has to go back to this original position. Let me duplicate this and let me drop it here. How do I duplicate it? Right click on it, you get duplicate. Right click means right mouse button on your keyboard. Press, bring your mouse pointer on it. Right mouse button on your keyboard. You get this option, add command, delete block, duplicate. When you click on duplicate, you get a duplicate one. And you can drag it wherever you want and click. It will be placed. Already we have duplicated it, so we don't want it. We'll just put it here so it disappears. So let's see how it works. Let's click on this. When I click on this, what should happen? It should glide to the hedgehog for 1 second, then there should be the sound, and it's gonna wait for 5 seconds, and it's gonna appear again here. Let's see this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ta-da! It came back. So that we can feed another apple. So the apple is done. Now let's see how to make this character dance. Or first we'll make this character sleep. First we'll make this character sleep. How can we make this character sleep? To make this character sleep, we have to change this costume. Costume in the sense, like the way it is. So now it is standing and facing this direction. But when it is sleeping, we'll go to costume and we'll see. we'll come to this fifth one. In costume, I clicked on this costume tab. I came to this fifth costume. It looks like it is sleeping. Can you see that? Yes, looks nice. So we'll just add some text over here which is saying sleep. Whenever you click on this, this character should sleep. And you see that whenever the flag is clicked, it's still sleeping. We don't want that. So we're gonna go to looks, and we're gonna go to costume, switch costume to, it is in looks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the fifth block, switch costume to. So we can switch between the costume. So if we go to costumes, so the hedgehog A, hedgehog B, hedgehog C, there is a names for all the costumes, and hedgehog A is this. So this should be our starting position, or it should supposed to look when we start the game. So what we'll do is we'll change it to hedgehog A. You can see that hedgehog A is this position. So however it is, even it might be sleeping, whenever we click on the flag, it should come back to this. Okay, so let me click on this. By clicking on this, it will change and come back. Click on the flag, it has to change. Whatever it is doing, it has to come to this position and the costume has to change. Now we will make another sprite. I told you, no, we can paint our own sprite. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna come over here, we're gonna go here, click on it. We got our own sprite. You can see the name of the sprite is sprite one. There is nothing in this. Now let me zoom out. By clicking on this minus, it will zoom out. By clicking on this plus, it will zoom in. By clicking on this, it will just fit. So here we are. Now let's add a text which says sleep, but before that also we'll add a backdrop. For the backdrop, I mean backdrop here. So you can also see a frame here. Whatever we do within the frame, that will appear here. If we do something out of the frame, that will not appear in the stage. So let me do some for the first thing. So we're gonna put the sleep text on this background. So this is a rectangle, or you can call it a square. You can click on this and we can draw a square like this. If you don't want this color, go here, change any color you want. Move the slider, you get different colors. You can choose that color, click on it, go to this mouse tool, click on it, expand this how much ever you want, expand it. If you want it rotate, you can rotate it, you can do anything. If you don't want it, click on this delete here. Yeah, so upon this we're gonna type sleep. So let me place it in the center. You can see this is the center of this rectangle, and for this frame, what you can see, this frame, the center is here. So we'll bring the rectangle center. So there is a plus on the rectangle. So we'll bring the rectangle center to the center of the frame. Okay, now let's add a text. Yeah, click on T and click on somewhere, and you can type SLEEP. So both the text line, the background color is same. Let's change the color of a text. Let's make it as white. White looks good on. White looks good on this color. Let's increase the size. Let's go to T again. And oh no, yeah, we can increase size like this. And let me put this thing also in the center, and also let me change this font. Yes, this looks nice, don't you think so? And it doesn't fit. Let's make it smaller, but don't pull it like this. It will stretch the image. If you want to resize the image, always try with the corner ones. Okay, see, it can resize it. You have to use the corner ones, not the center one. Center one will stretch this one and this one. It will stretch the image. We don't want to stretch the image. Just we are interested only in Control Z, come back. Yes, Control Z is to undo. And also you can click on this to undo anything if you have done something wrong. For example, if I stretch this, I don't want this. Click on this, it will come back. And click on this, it will redo. When you click on this, it will be undo. Okay, this looks perfect. Sleep looks perfect, and it is very big on the screen. You can see that. So let's reduce the size of the sprite panel, and let's put it to 60. Yes, this looks good. Let me put it here, and let me reduce it a little more. So it says sleep. It's time to make it sleep. So we'll go back here, we'll click on the hedgehog. First we'll go to the sleep. In the sleep, what we're going to do is when this sprite is clicked. So this is also considered as a sprite. We're going to go to events. When this sprite is clicked, what is this? You can see it here. That's sleep. When the sleep is clicked, what should happen? It should send an invisible message. It's going to send an invisible message that is called as broadcast. So where we can find that? We're going to find that in events. In events, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The seventh block, it says broadcast the message. So using this message, we can broadcast we can send an invisible message. Okay, so let's create, it says broadcast image one. Let's click, let's give a new name for it. Let's give it as sleep. This will be the name for the invisible message we're gonna send. Okay, whenever we click on this, there's gonna be an invisible message sent. And whenever the invisible message is sent, that is sleep, when I receive sleep, that is whenever I receive an invisible message sleep, what this character should do, which characters now we are in? We are in the hedgehog. Whenever you are doing this coding, please make sure you are in that particular character. Sometimes what happens, you might be doing something here instead of doing an hedgehog, you are in apple. So always if you want to do something, make sure you are in the that particular character and you are doing the coding. So when I receive a sleep, so here when I click on this, we are sending a invisible message saying sleep. When I receive a invisible message that is sleep, what should happen? They should change this costume to this costume, which is that hedgehog E. Okay, where is hedgehog E costumes? We're gonna go to looks, and in looks we have switch costume to, and that is E. Yes. And whenever, yes, let me click on this. You can see that it is sleeping, but it has to sleep only for a few minutes. So what we'll do is we'll go to E control and we'll just give it as 1 second or 2 second or 3 second. Let's give it as 2 second. And what we're going to do is for 2 second, going to sleep and going to change this costume again to the original costume. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch costume. The original costume name is A. Yeah, it has to switch to this. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 1, 2. Only for 2 seconds waits and it comes back. Let it sleep for 4 seconds. And it also has to make a noise, correct? When it's sleeping, snoring sound. So for that, what we can do is we're gonna go to sound. We don't have a snoring sound. We have only pop sound. We'll go to this, we can choose a sound, and snoring, S-N-O-R. So, by placing a mouse cursor on this plane, we can listen to the sound. So let's go back, we got the sound. How to add the sound to this? Let's go to sound, and we have this block which is snoring. We can click on this, yeah, snoring. So let's click on start. Click on sleep. Yeah, we can increase it a little bit more. Fine. Yes, it slept for 5 seconds and it came back. This is how we can make him sleep. And last but not the least, we're going to make him dance. For that, what we're going to do is, before that, and also we just forgot. Sometimes people may move this somewhere. People might move this anywhere. So whenever we click on the flag, it has to come back to this position. That is when flag is clicked, we're gonna go to motion and we're gonna take this block. So currently it is at x is minus 156 and y is 131. Go to, even if we put it anywhere, when we click on the flag, it's gonna come back. Whenever we drag it any position, when you click on the flag, it's going to come back to this position. So nothing and nobody can mess with our code or any mess with our objects on the stage. Now the last one, let's go for the dance. When I click on dance, this character has to dance for a while. So for this, let me go to paint, let me add the same thing. We can zoom out so they can see the frame and draw a rectangle. So this is a white rectangle. Let me change it. So if this both the sliders are at the second slider and the third slider are at the extreme right, then you can see the different colors. If it is not in the extreme right, you can't see any colors. Make sure this and this are in the extreme ends. So let me make a green one. And how can we increase the size of it? Click on it. First, you have to change the tool to the selected tool. And you're gonna increase the size. And let me place it in the center. And yeah, it is huge here, but let's shrink it later. So this is here. And inside this, we're gonna place a dance text. So I've clicked on T. Let me change the color to white. So D-A-N-C-E, dance. In color, that's why it's not visible. Let me put it here. And also let me increase the size, put it in the center. Yes, looks nice, little bit down. Yes, looks perfect. Now you can reduce the size in sprite panel. Let me do it for 40. And let's place it on the top here. We'll go back to the code and we'll fix the position. That is when the flag is clicked. Go to this position, that is 154139, 154139. So when I click on this, even it has to send an invisible message. How can I do this? Go to events. When this sprite is clicked, broadcast an invisible message called as, click on new message. I'll call this message as dance. Sorry, dance, D-A-N-C-E, dance. On okay, by clicking on this, it's gonna dance for us. So that we have done here, we'll go back to the hedgehog and we'll make it to dance. So whenever I receive an invisible message called as dance, you can see that by clicking on this, I can change it to sleep also, but already we have it for the sleep. Let be dance. Whenever I receive a dance message, that is an invisible message, the character should dance. To make it dance, we're gonna take these. So if we go to costumes, so we're going to switch between these two or these three. If I switch between these three costumes, you can see that it looks like it is dancing. The leg moves and the head moves. So let me switch between the costumes. How can I switch between the costumes? Here the costume, switch costume, switch costume. We're going to switch between the first three, this, this and this. So these three things together, it seems to be like it is dancing. So that is, first one is hedgehog A, hedgehog, second one is hedgehog B, the third one is hedgehog C. Hedgehog C. But when I click on this, there's nothing happening because there is no, what happens, it continuously, it just goes here. There is no wait in between. If you have a, if you add a wait block, then it would look nice. Then we can see how it actually changes. So let me duplicate this also. So what happens here is, whenever we receive a invisible dance message, dance message, it's gonna first switch to B, because already it will be in A. It's gonna switch to B, next to C, and again to A, then to, yeah, this is perfect. So it's gonna switch to B, switch C, switch A. Between this, we'll add a wait block. In controls, we get this wait. So watch now. You can see that. And let's reduce the time to 0.5 seconds. That's less than one. It looks like this, like moves. And let's put a repeat block. It's gonna repeat it for certain number of time. So it's gonna repeat for 10 times. You can see this, the same thing gonna happen. The same thing's gonna happen for 10 times. And we also need our music for the dance. Where do we get the music? Just like how we got the sound, we're gonna get the music. We're gonna go to sound, click on this, this sprite. And you can see there are many We'll go to effects, we'll go to loops, or else we can type something called as dance, so we can see. This sound is nice. Let's click on this. So it's here. Go back to the code. Sound. So start this sound and gonna repeat like this. So let's see. So how was it? So we are at the end of the session. I hope you all enjoyed it. So we created a virtual pet called Hedgehog. There's an hedgehog here. We didn't name this character. If you want, you can name this character. So whenever we click on the flag, it's gonna say his name. So we can go to the looks and we can take this blocks. So let's put it over here. So it's gonna say, sorry for that. Hi. I am, call it as any name. Let me call it as Siri, because I don't find any name as of now. So what happens when I click on the flag? It says I am Siri. And if you want still something more, you can add to this. You can use another block, or you can still edit the same. And clicking on the fruit, it eats the fruit. After some time, the fruit is gonna come back, so that we can feed the animal again. Let's click on sleep. So it's gonna sleep for some time. And clicking on dance. It's gonna dance for us for a while. That's it for the day. Stay tuned with us. We're gonna see like there's many more things, and see you then. Bye bye, tata.